Correct, children. Let us see the another important factor which affects the flora or fauna of any particular regions. That is one thing is climate. Okay, in climate, how the temperature affects? So, what is the influence of temperature? We know that the character and extent of vegetation are mainly determined by temperature along with humidity in the air. So, temperature also influences the variety of plants exist in any area. We can say also precipitation and soil. We have already studied land and soil, how they influence the growth of different varieties of plants. Here, temperature also is very important. We know some of the regions where equatorial regions, there is heavy temperature here because of that very tall trees are grown here. So precipitation is or the rainfall, the amount of rainfall is important. Soil, humidity, air of etc. are also very important. Now the on the slopes of the Himalayas, we can find the hills or the peninsula above the height of 915 meters high regions are there. So that these regions are particular areas where the temperature affects the all types of vegetation growth here. So it, we know that India, which is lying in the tropical region, Tropic of Cancer passing through the middle of India. So the northern part of the Tropic of Cancer, we know Himalaya Mountains, Northern Plains and Himalaya Mountains are there. When the southern part of the Tropic of Cancer, the peninsular India, we can observe the different types of climate in the two sides of the north and the south of the Tropic of Cancer. In the extreme northern part of India, we know that extreme north, we have the Himalaya Mountains, completely snow covered regions. Okay, so temperature also is different in these regions. The Himalayan mountains, we can find alpine vegetation. So what do we say the photo period or the sunlight period? How much of the amount is received by the earth for a particular period of time? We know when we are moving towards the higher latitudes, that means in the polar regions, the temperature is different. It's extreme cold regions. So while moving towards the equatorial regions, temperature is very high. It is extreme hot regions. So the variation in duration of sunlight in different places due to its differences in latitude, altitude, season and duration of the day. When in the equatorial regions, so more sunlight is experienced. So sunlight is exhausting in the equatorial regions is very high. We know that it is almost vertical, and polar regions there is a sloping sunlight. So the distance from the polar regions to the sun is very much or huge, so that the cold regions we can find or the frigid regions are in the polar regions. So which are the regions more sunlight is observed? These regions we can find the trees grow very fast in summer. So some regions, especially the equatorial regions, very tall trees with dense forests can be found here. Heavy rainfall also occur in the equatorial regions. Then another important factor is precipitation. Rainfall is very important for the growth of and plants in any area. So in India, we know that the entire rainfall is brought by the advancing monsoon. That is the southwest monsoon, which originates from the coast of Kerala in the month of June. June to September, that is the period of southwest monsoon or the advancing monsoon. And another monsoon is the retreating monsoon, which is coming from northeast regions. These two are the monsoon seasons we have. So during these two seasons, especially we get the highest rainfall. So the precipitation is high during this period only, these monsoons only. So which are the regions or the areas that receive the heavy rainfall? There we can find more dense vegetation or the thick or densely found trees are growing in these regions. So which are the regions have less rainfall, especially in the desert regions of Rajasthan? These regions we can find short trees, especially the shrubs or bushy plants or the thorny plants. So why forests are important for human beings? We know that due to the precipitation sub regions there are dense forests. Why these are important for human beings? We know that forests are renewable resources and play a major role in enhancing the quality of environment, which means it promotes ecological balance. So they modify local climate. Which regions, if there are forests, the local climate is influenced by the forest cover of particular area. Also, they control soil erosion. Another thing is they can control soil erosion and regulate the stream flow. What are the smaller rivers or streams are flowing? They also flow in these forests or plants regulate the streams flow. Then another one is they support varieties of industries. We know that paper industry, which is we are obtaining the trees for the paper, making paper pulp, and many types of industries are also depending upon the forest or the trees. They also provide, most importantly, livelihood for many communities. They are living in the forest regions. We know that the tribals especially depend upon the forest resources only. So another one important factor is that they also attract many tourists there. So recreation purposes, people move to the forest regions. This is also, these are all important advantages of forests. We know that also they control wind force, temperature also can be regulated due to the forest. Another thing is they cause the rainfall also due to, so almost these are all over the world. If there are trees or plants, or if there is dense forest, those regions we can experience the heavy rainfall. So these are all importance of forest. They also provide humans to the soil and shelter to the wild animals. Another thing is the wild animals live in the forest largely. So India has different varieties of plants here, especially natural vegetation. There are many changes also occurring due to different reasons. That one thing is growing demand for cultivated lands. We are also deforesting the land, forest. That is one thing. And we are, when population is increasing, we need more and more food grains. So cultivation of food grains to be increased. So we are expanding more regions for cultivating the crops or agriculture purpose. Another one is urbanization is taking over grazing or mining, or industries are also developing. Because of these reasons, we are cutting the trees. So deforestation is largely taking place here. So in India, there are some parts, large parts is no more natural in the real sense. That means many of the plants, naturally existing plants, we have cut down. So except in some inaccessible regions like the high mountains or the Himalaya mountains, people, and it is not much disturbed by the humans, or there is no, very less human interference in the hilly regions of the Himalaya mountains. So some of the regions in the central India are also Marusthali, especially we say about the desert regions in Rajasthan, Thar desert regions. These are not much explored by the people because of the inaccessibility of the these regions. So human beings are not much interfered in these regions. Okay, according to India, we know that the state of forest report 2011, the forest cover in India is 21.05% only. That is less than prescribed by the United Nations organization. Okay, so the minimum 33% of forest cover should be there in any nation. We have less than that, 21.05% of forest cover only we have. So we need to plant more and more trees and increase the afforestation or increase the forest cover. Now different types of vegetation we have. We said many types of plants or vegetation can be found or available in our country. Especially they are identified as tropical evergreen forest, tropical deciduous forest, tropical thorn forest and scrubs. montane forest, mangrove forest, etc. So about all these different types of vegetation we will study more in the next class.